not the type of guy that says, I told you so. Well, actually I am. Since the very beginning of the Idaho 4 murders, I've been saying that pretty much ever since I saw the video, based on mannerisms, based on everything, I believe that it was an incel, someone that was rejected, and I believe it was the hoodie guy in the food truck video. Well, his name is Jack, or John, Showalter, and he has apparently left the country. I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time with JB Gunner. Let's go ahead and get on in this. We got a little bit, and maybe by the end of this video, you will agree with me that this seems pretty obvious. Let's do it. Bring it back. I have no clue why somebody would try to say that it's not the hoodie guy. Could it be because the family is filthy rich and they donate to the school and they donate to the city? And now currently, rumor has it that they're off in Africa without John Showalter, Jack Showalter, giving a DNA test for this current situation. You gotta ask yourself, how would the Moscow Police Department, Sheriff's Department allow this to happen? That is the conversation we will be having today, because it's not just me that questions it. The father, Stephen Gonclaves, or whatever the fuck his name is, he is also questioning it. And we got a lot more that we're going to be talking about in today's video on Idaho. Guys, before we get into this, I'm going to say first and foremost, thank you. Terabyte that supports this channel. Regardless of the method you choose, whether it's Cash App, Patreon, Venmo, truth is, guys, I couldn't do this each and every day as often as I do without you guys, the Gun Squad. So thank you so much for all your support. And if you too want to join the Gun Squad, if my message has value to you, feel free to hit the links down below. No better time than now. They've tried to shut me down. They tried to cancel me, but I keep coming back. Guys, while you're down there, make sure you subscribe to all my other YouTube channels, as well as my Odyssey and Rumble, because a lot of you guys whine and complain when I get taken down and you can't find me. Best way to find me is on Twitter or Odyssey and Rumble. That way, strikes or suspensions or not, you guys can always find me. All right, let's get to this story, because this is a big one. For you guys that do not know, the Idaho 4, this is four college kids that were brutally slaughtered in a targeted attack, I believe, on Kaylee in the Gonclaves in this situation. In the beginning of this, I said, listen, these two beautiful women right here, in my opinion, they were the target. It's going to be some incel, some dude that was rejected, and then all the incels got mad. The incels started commenting and was like, oh, are you trying to demonize the incels? Yeah, because you guys are weird people. Of course I'm trying to demonize you. Well, you guys are bad people. You believe that despite your inability to get a woman, you believe women somehow owe you some pussy. No, you got to provide good dick, and you got to provide a sense of humor. You got to provide something in value for them as well. And since you don't, you get no pussy. Yeah, I could be, I'm 42 years old, have no problem getting pussy. You know why? Because I'm funny and I dick them right. But you have problems, and so they reject you, and so you believe they should die. You believe they should be murdered because they do not wish to engage in sexual activity with you. That's the reality of the story. Now, we're going to talk about a young man, a very well-off young man in terms of wealth. His name is John Jack Showalter. Believe it or not, it's the hoodie guy from the video. And we're going to go ahead and get to this, because we're going to start off. By the way, that's him right there. Dad of slain Idaho student, Kaylee Gonclaves, whatever the fuck, turns to PIs as cops are too inexperienced, he says. He goes on to say. There's a key element in this article I want you guys to see, and we'll get there. The grieving father of murdered University of Idaho student Kaylee Gonclaves is working with his own private investigators, which I think is smart, because he fears cops in the major case are too inexperienced, which I believe he's actually correct. One of the murder squad officers is only 26, he complained. You guys know my view on this. You guys know me personally. Hold on, let me fix this fucking shit. You guys know me personally. I do a lot of political commentary. And that's one of my complaints about people in general, is that if you're fucking 25, 26 years old, you can't tell me about shit. Your little young ass hasn't experienced life enough to tell me about anything. And I know there's going to be some people that disagree with that. But chances are, if you're disagreeing with that, you're one of the young motherfuckers that think you're a know-it-all. I thought I knew it all when I was 26, too. But it is what it is. So I don't disagree with him here. So one of the squad officers is only 26, he complained, meaning he was only 19 when the city of Moscow had its last murder in 2015. That's a good point. In a town that hasn't had a murder in 7 years, having a cop that's 26 years old isn't very fruitful. There's no way in fuck he can have any experience in murder investigations when he's 26 years old and the fucking town doesn't have any murders. Let's call it what it is. So they're just inexperienced, he says. I don't want anyone making mistakes in my child's case, and I don't blame him. Now, let's get to what he actually think. Let's go ahead and get to one of the situations that he thinks is the problem. We're going to go on down here. He basically said that they let people off the hook too soon. But I want you to pay attention to this one. He admitted that he also fears that a hoodie-wearing man spotted lingering near his daughter and her best friend, Madison Mogan, was ruled out too quickly for killing the pair and their two friends. That's exactly what I said. Some people came to us and said he's out of the country. He didn't take a DNA test. Bam! Bingo! Bingo! And that, so the father's on it as well. Now, if this was untrue, the police would come out and say, you know, he took a DNA test. But that's not happened yet. The police have heard this interview. They've even responded on Twitter to all kinds of other allegations. But you know the one allegation they did not respond to? This one. They have not responded to the Jack allegation at all. He says, so we would like police to tell us what his alibi was. Actually, let me tell you what his alibi was. Let me go here. His alibi came from his parents. Apparently, after the food truck, where these people had been out drinking and having a ball, he drove 5 hours to their cabin in the mountains. This was at 3 o'clock. Or 1 o'clock in the morning, I think they were at the food truck. Let me ask you a question. What is the likelihood of a college kid, after drinking and shit, taking a 5-hour trip to his mother's in the mountains? What is the likelihood of that existing in the middle of the night? I understand. It's possible. But the official narrative, the official alibi with Jack John Showalter is that he was out. He got kicked out of the bar. Let's make this clear. He got kicked out of the fraternity for being inappropriate with women. He gets kicked out of the bar. He gets kicked out of the fraternity. He's drinking at the bar, got kicked out. He goes to Grubhub. He's not even having food. You see him stalking Kaylee and them. And then immediately when they leave, he runs off. And then apparently we're supposed to believe that he drove 5 hours away, 5 hours and 29 minutes actually, to his mother's house in the mountains, to the cabin? Why? Why would someone drive in the middle of the night in a situation where they're obviously hanging out and having fun with friends? Why would they drive 5 hours away unless they needed a desperate alibi? They needed an emergency alibi because some shit just went wrong. Now, so we would like the police to tell us what his alibi was, saying he would be able to move on if they could confirm it was solid. Vague mismessaging on whether the killer likely targeted at least one of the four roommates and why could also lead to a dangerously false sense of security. I've heard people talk to reporters and say they'd be way more scared if it wasn't targeted. And that's what the reason that they're saying a lot of these things. They want to keep this town. You got to understand. They're trying to keep people in this town not to be scared. It's a public relations situation, right? The college brings in so much revenue. I think I heard it was like 50% of the revenue of the economy in this town is the college kids. And so when you're looking at a situation where you got 15,000 college kids potentially coming in next semester, and they're like, hey, we can't scare these little motherfuckers. That is why we are in this situation. But we got all kinds of shit. They got fingerprints. Let me show you this shit. Fingerprints, handprint was found on the window of the slain Idaho student's home. Now keep, I want you to remember, keep Jack and John in your mind. Now obviously you take a look at that. That looks like a pretty decent sized hand.
Be the killer's handprint. The ghostly image appeared when this window was dusted for prints.
There's no doubt that it's an important item of evidence. There has to be a point of entry and a point of exit in a crime like this. If there is a handprint, it may be very significant. I can
show you. And we're learning that 21-year-old Kaylee Gonsalves may have been the killer's prime target. Published reports say that Kaylee was subjected to a more brutal attack than the other three victims. She was killed on the same bed along with her best friend, Madison Mogan.
Ain't it odd how in the very beginning I said these two would be the target? Ain't it odd and crazy how I said it? And y'all called me sexist. Well, you're saying that just because they're hotter. Yes, that's exactly why I said it. And it doesn't make me a bad guy for noticing things the way they were. It doesn't make me a bad guy, especially when I end up being right. So they were the target. And chances are, and this is still just theory, the incel to me, and I don't care how rich or how young and fit and attractive you think this guy is, it doesn't make him not an incel. We can go back to all popular incels throughout time. And they're not necessarily fat or fucked up looking, right? Let's call it what it is. Who was the dude in California that did the video essay and killed like and shot like 9 people? I forgot his damn name, but popular amongst the incels. I mean, he wasn't a bad looking, fucked up looking guy. He looked a little homo, but he wasn't a bad looking guy. Let's call it what it is. So currently, it appears that I'm right that these two, particularly Kaylee, was the target. And we'll get to him. We're going to get to Jack and John because to me, clearly, he's the guy.
News Nation reporter Brian Enten is in Idaho covering the investigation.
There's a number of different theories possible. Since her wounds were more significant than Maddie's, is it possible she was the target? Yes. Or is it possible that she woke up and was trying to fight back and that Maddie was the target?
That's possible.
As the investigation enters its fourth week, Kaylee's father is expressing disappointment with the local police.
Do you feel confident in the police investigation and the people investigating right now?
I do not feel confident, and that's why I push the envelope and say a little bit more. I hate to be that guy, but you know, there's a job to do for everybody has a job and a role to play in this.
That's right.
This is my role as the parent.
He says he's raising money to hire a private detective. The two surviving roommates who slept through the attack are breaking their silence. Poignant letters from Dylan Mortensen and Bethany Funk were read aloud by a pastor at a memorial service in an Idaho church. Dylan wrote,
I know it will be hard to not have the four of them in our lives, but I know...
Now, so right now, the father seems to believe, to at least be somewhat suspicious of my man Jack. There's all over the place. People are talking about, did they rule out individuals too fast? Let's check this out from News Nation.
Homicide Detective Sergeant Bill Cannon and Detective Phil Grimaldi, they have worked hundreds of murder cases and now host the popular podcast called Police Off the Cuff. Gentlemen, thank you for being here tonight. Sergeant Cannon, I'm going to begin with you. How fast is too fast to clear a suspect in a case this severe, 4 victims of a brutal homicide?
You know, I think that there's a mistaken point that they're thinking that someone is cleared. You can always bring someone back in if evidence and other people's or witnesses tell you that the person is involved. You have to be careful of pushing too hard on someone that you're interviewing because they can always lawyer up and then the interview is over. So they can still peripherally conduct the investigation and determine that the person is cleared. The person's never cleared until
exactly
the investigation or there's an arrest made.
Exactly. You know? By the way, I want to make something clear to all you fucking feminists that's going to flip out. I just want to make this clear. I'm speaking from a man's perspective. And God, as I'm just going to be honest with you. If a man is going to kill for some pussy, or if a man's going to kill because he got rejected, it ain't going to be some ugly broad. You see what I'm saying? That's a high risk thing. And I have very, no reward really. I'm just saying that we don't get too angry like if an ugly broad says, nah, you can't get none of this. You see what I'm saying? That's why, and you may think it's horrible and sexist and all of this, but let's not bullshit here. Kaylee is clearly the model. They're all pretty attractive, but Kaylee is clearly the model-esque individual in this case. Now you can just say that's your personal opinion. That's all good. But all I'm saying is from a man's perspective, if I'm going to throw my life away, if I'm going to commit these acts, if it's going to get me so worked up, if I'm going to risk it all, why wouldn't I pick the hottest one? Does that make sense? Why wouldn't she be the one? You see what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to, you know, it just is what it is. But, you know, I'm not going to be upset because Lizzo didn't give me no pussy and start killing people. You see what I'm saying? And I know that, I get it. You're going to say that sounds horrible. But just because you're not thinking from a male perspective, you got to think of what would be worth it. And I'm not saying it's worth it or good or anything like that. But in a killer's mind, in an incel's mind, in someone that is willing to kill over romance or over being rejected, it's going to probably be the hottest one there. It just likelihood says it'll be the hottest one there. That's just my point. And so I get it. You're going to say I'm a sexist. You're going to say all that dumb shit. But it doesn't erase the fact that what I'm saying is factual. Or at least solid, you know, opinion. Because why? I'm a fucking dude. If I'm going to lose it all, I might as well go for the hottest one. You see what I'm saying?
No, so I think that they're erring on this, that he's cleared. They can always bring him back in if they have evidence against him.
Who's them?
So, Detective Grimaldi, jump in on that and tell me about, you know, the kinds of alibis that would have the police say publicly so soon in the case, nope, nothing to see here. I found it odd. I've covered a lot of murders, too, and I'm used to the public saying, everyone's under an umbrella of suspicion.
That's right.
Absolutely. I think that the fact that he did interact with those people around that food truck, he was probably pretty easily to identify and interview. Perhaps he did have a concrete alibi. Let's say he was on videotape somewhere. Someone said, or it was reported, that he drove 5 hours to a relative's home.
Right. 5 hours to a relative home in the middle of the night. Come on, man.
Did his cell phone travel that 5 hours? Did they clear him with that? Just because a person gives a story doesn't mean that we're going to buy it right away. We're going to try and corroborate it, whether it be through technology, cell phone cameras. If I find the person that the person who the hoodie guy says he was with, I want to talk to that person. I want to ask them, was he with you? What was the amount of time that he was with you? Is there any way to corroborate that you're telling the truth? Is there a video camera? Do you have a Ring doorbell camera? Those are the type of things that I think I would be looking for. And I have to piggyback what Bill just said. 100%. Just because he's been cleared does not mean if further evidence is developed or interviews point at this particular individual, doesn't mean he can't be put back into the suspect room.
Does it mean anything, Bill, that the family of Kaylee Gonzalez has heard and learned in some way that he is out of the country now and that he did not submit a DNA? It would seem to me if you're going to clear someone, you'd say, you know, spit in the cup on your way out. Nothing personal.
Bam.
But yeah, we'll clear you, but
exactly.
Just give us what
exactly.
we need to cross our T's and dot the I's.
You know, we had recommended early on in this investigation that every single person they interviewed, they asked for voluntarily to swab for DNA and to take major case fingerprints, because also down the road, they may need.
See, I haven't heard that. I haven't seen anything that says that they asked for everyone's DNA. Do you know why I know that? Because there's another person they talked to that was also there. You guys know who I'm talking about? Hold on, give me just a second. I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you just real quick. I'm going to show you, right? Remember Joe V? Hold on. Remember him right there? Joe Vidot.
Like they were trying to ditch him. So that's sus.
He's literally talking about Jack S. in this video. And we're going to get to this. They didn't swab him for DNA. So that entire statement is flat out bullshit. They did not swab everybody there for DNA. Why would Hoodie Man be a suspect and not, let's say, Joe V? That's all I'm saying. They both were there. They both communicated with the girls. Now, I get it. To me, Hoodie Man is the suspect. But the claim that they DNA swabbed all of them is not accurate. And you have to say, why would they swab Hoodie Man, but not anyone else that's in that general vicinity? The town's only, it's small, right? Let's be honest here. Let's go ahead and continue.
Elimination DNA and elimination fingerprints, when they do arrest someone, so if this case goes to trial, because a clever defense attorney will be pointing at all the different fingerprints and DNA that's inside that house.
Yeah.
Thank you for
but
watching.
At the end of the day, I don't think they did it. So I think what we're seeing is confirmation that my man left the country. I think that currently is what we are seeing. And I actually saw a couple of interesting videos that I do want to present to you. But I want to also show you this. This is Jack Showalter's mother, okay? I want you to see right there. They go to Kenya all the time. This is a regular thing for them. They're wealthy people. And there's nothing wrong with being wealthy at all. But these people go to Kenya all the time. Now, you see that photo right there of Jack. There's actually something a little bit more intense that I'm going to show you, and I'm going to hope that YouTube allows me to show you. I want to show, well, in fact, let me start off by saying I have video or images of him with, I guess you could just say, mutilated carcasses, right? Which is okay. People hunt. He's an avid hunter. And granted, as an avid hunter, having that knife right there. In fact, I'll just show you that instead of all of it. Because the rest is just a carcass. It's just carcass, right? You see the guts and shit like that. He seems actually pretty skilled with a fixed blade, wouldn't you say? Like, wouldn't you say if I was to show you the images, you would understand he's skilled. But look right there. Look right there. Ain't that the exact type of knife they said the killer would have? So Jack is skilled with this, avid hunter. And a lot of people in Idaho are, a lot of people are, and I'm not knocking that. But I want you to see this, because clearly this could be part of this. Hoodie guy seen with Idaho victims at the food truck was allegedly kicked out of the fraternity. He was kicked out of the fraternity and that bar that night, okay? We all know what's going on here, but the father obviously wants to know a little bit more about the food truck guy. Idaho police previously confirmed that the man in the video has been ruled out, but didn't even reveal his name. After assuming his identity, followers of the case have started digging through Showalter's social media accounts, mentions, tags, and anything that might give them a clue as to who the guy is. Reddit users claim Showalter was recently kicked out of his fraternity, chapter of Delta Tau Delta, which he was in, at the University of Idaho for inappropriate behavior towards women at parties, began popping up everywhere on forums while discussing the crimes. Now, this is without an official source. They did, however, uncover photos from Showalter's mother's Facebook in 2015 that shows him in the process of hunting, standing in front of torn apart animals' carcasses with various hunting knives littered across the ground. Many believe that one of the hunting knives on the ground was a K-bar style knife. Moscow Police Department has reportedly been asking local businesses if they sold that same blade. Now, I'm going to show you this video from A Crime Amongst Us. I want to show you this right here. Very, very important video that you're going to see right here. Let me see if I can make this bigger. Let's see if I can make it. Give me just a second. Let me see if I can make this a little bit bigger so you guys can get a better view of this. This is actually a really impressive video. And I want you guys to be able to see it. Okay? It says notices. This is him. If you know, in the beginning, you'll notice that he notices the camera. Remember when I showed you this video to begin with? He puts the hood up and all that. Let's start this over. Let's start over. Here he is. Look at Jack back there. Hat backwards, all of that. Notices the camera. Takes his hat, turns it right side out, and it puts his hoodie up. See him? See him? Look at that. Doing literally nothing but watching him. Look, we've talked about this before.
Watch this. That was a solid rush. It's a good thing that it ended, but...
She points at him and says, fuck you.
This is Friday and Saturday in a row.
She pointed at him and said, fuck you. Like, if you listen really well, you can hear it. Listen.
That was a solid rush. It's a good thing that it ended, but...
Said, fuck you, right there.
This is Friday and Saturday in a row.
Literally pointed right up. Then they immediately takes off. Now watch Jack. Watch Jack. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him. I want you to see that right there. Look at the hand symbol. Look, the hand sign. He's like, what the fuck, man? You know that's exactly what that meant. When he looked over at him, he was like, That's the what the fuck? Where the fuck you going? That's exactly what it is. Look, right there. And then now watch this. Now he takes off, scurries off. Look how quick he's going. Look how quick he ran off. I was talking to Mindy in the comment section, one of the gun squad, right? And she said he didn't run off. No, there you have it. Okay, he didn't jog. That was pretty fast though, Mindy.
Why would Kaylee's sister, Alavia, be so intrigued by this comment?
Yep, about him going overseas.
She commented this yesterday. Today is December 3rd. J.S. refers to the hooded man in the video.
Jack Showalter.
The same person who is willing to post the following photos on social media and lived in the apartments next to the girls.
Next to the girls.
Exact knife type they are looking for. Two of them, in fact.
Bam!
He was also kicked out of his fraternity for anger issues and kicked out of the corner club for being weird to girls.
That bar, that night. He was kicked out of that bar.
Pause to read.
Watch this.
The term GeoSnap is a Snapchat setting that allows your location to be untraceable.
Watch this.
His only alibi is that he took off to his parents' cabin 5 hours away.
Now he had a geo snap right there.
I believe the police say not believe to be involved at this time is to try to trick him.
People are strange when you're a stranger. Faces look ugly when you're alone. Women seem wicked.
Please share when your opinions and comments.
Streets are uneven.
So, that is what we got from there, and that's a hell of a video, right? Let's just call it what it is. That's a hell of a video. Other people are seeing this, but let's look at this. What was in Jack's pocket here?
Yes, edit the lighting. And do I even have to explain this one?
Look at that.
Looks like a certain shape to me.
Look at that. That's not his dick.
And why does your left hand literally never leave that same pocket or a belt area under the shirt except to fix your hat?
Ask the question. Come on, man. Adjusting pocket belt area. Watch carefully. Look at him. Look at him.
That was a solid rush. It's a good thing that...
And of course was told, fuck you, right? Scurries off. Watch this shit. Hold on.
If you were so concerned about the girls getting home...
Look at the hoodie.
...and took off to your parents' cabin 5 hours away, right? After this, your alibi, why weren't you the one to give them a safe ride home? Too much evidence that way, right?
Exactly. Exactly.
Yes, edit the lighting. And do I...
So, you got to ask yourselves. You got to ask yourselves what's going on here. Now, I get it. All of this could be coincidence. It could. It definitely could. Maybe Jack has nothing to do with any of this shit. Maybe him getting kicked out of the fraternity. Maybe him getting kicked out of the bar that night. Maybe all of this is just coincidence. But let's listen to Joe V. Let's listen to Joe V talk about, well, he's answering a little bit of these questions.
And it also seemed like he was pissed that they ditched him.
Woo! Which is hold on. Shout out to Conspiracy for this clip. Let this sink in. That's Joe. Now, remember,
Like they were trying to ditch him. So that's sus. And it also seemed like he was pissed that they ditched him, which is also sus. And he was standing in line with me, who was waiting for food, but he, after watching the video, homeboy never ordered food. He never even went up to the counter.
Exactly. You don't say. So somebody was mad that they were rejected? Oh, man, I recall saying that a fucking month ago. Go ahead.
Also sus. So, I could understand why people think it's him, but we don't know anything. Yeah, I remember she said that because, she turned around because I think he said, like, oh, my God, because she was, like, really drunk and was doing, like, it was kind of funny. She was, like, trying to grab food and stuff, and I think she turned around and said, hey, like, fuck you. Like, then she was, like, saying it to him, like, don't laugh at me kind of thing. I've been craving that ever since I heard about it on Google the menu, but I'm in Australia. Well, Jade, I was earlier, there was a guy on here from Australia and I was showing him my Bloodstones. I was like, God bless you guys for making Bloodstones.
Come on, fucker.
I love those shoes. Those are like, I wear them like all the time. And Bloodstones. Did they even speak to him? Yeah, they talked several times. Yes, and you see Maddie taking a picture above her head of him. She wasn't. So I don't know why people keep saying that. That wasn't happening.
Let me just show you why there are people saying this. As there are YouTube channels and people out here that are theorizing that Maddie, Kaylee, right here, takes a picture of Jack. Here we go.
Love it. $23.
Now watch. That does seem potentially, I'm going to be honest, maybe not. Maybe it's just a selfie. But why wouldn't she take a selfie like with her? Like, I don't know. I don't know. But this is why people are saying it.
Do you guys have any NFC, Go-Go Ben? Any, whatever.
You would think that if she was taking a picture of her friend Maddie, but she wasn't. And her sister knew what she was trying to do. Listen here. This is her sister. Her sister's about to talk. Hold on.
She's also raising questions about why her sister called a young man named Jack multiple times the night she was slain.
At 2:26 a.m., Kaylee starts to call Jack. Kaylee calls Jack six times between 2:26 a.m. to 2:44 a.m.
That was the boyfriend, though, I believe.
Gosh, I give you a lot of credit.
That was the boyfriend, though. This woman says, I don't think this is the boyfriend Jack she was asking questions about. And that, it does make sense since her sister knew the boyfriend Jack. Wouldn't she have just said, okay, she was calling her boyfriend? Does that make sense? But I think it's confirmed she called the boyfriend Jack. So, anyway, so obviously six calls from Kaylee to Jack. There's all kinds. Just Kaylee's sister thinks people were cleared too soon. A lot of people believe that. Why was the Moscow Police Department so concerned with clearing the name of John Jack Showalter with their first and second presser? Which they did. There you go. Ortho doctor, doctor, doctor. Adopted from Kenya. Possibly adopted. They think that maybe even Jack's adopted. How much of a financial contribution do the Showalters make to the University of Idaho? Let's take a look at some of this right here. There's John Jack with a black eye as a kid. That's him right there. There's a little bit more information on Jack and John. Or Jack. What is the who is the real John / Jack Showalter? His big bro was a stud quarterback. Let's see here. There's some of his information. So this is definitely the right dude. There's the Delta Tau Delta. That was the frat that he got kicked out of. There you have it right there. There's the man right there. And that is Hoodie Guy. It's not, you can clearly see it. It's Hoodie Guy. Clearly. Now, Kaylee was murdered more brutally, which is true. Let's see here. What we got here? So many bizarre things happen. Meet Dakota Goldman, who claims to be in the same area as Kaylee and knows her. This is what she posted on November 12th, that Saturday of the murders. Let's see what she posted. Now, I have no clue what the fuck that is. You gave me hope. Then this is what she posted on the 13th. Begging you to love me was the cruelest thing I ever did to myself. I'm not sure what all that was. Dakota says, Kaylee, I will love you, baby. Always have, always will. That's cool. These are just different little news and notes and tidbits that you get across the internet. After Kaylee's mother referenced the boogeyman on our latest interview, I went back to check out the post by Dakota. She did. I'm not sure I see anything different. Is there something over here? Wasn't that thing on the wall the first time? Wasn't that thing on the wall the first time? I'm a little concerned. I'm a little curious. Okay, this is right. So what's the problem here? This is what she posted on the 13th. Okay. I'm not seeing anything any different. Hold on. And then this is the new one. I don't see anything different here. Do you? For some reason, she took that and made it a big deal. I'm not seeing what was different here. I'm not seeing what was different there. But hey, you know, internet sleuths do internet sleuthy shit. I'm curious how long Kaylee and her boyfriend were separated for and if they were during the time happened between Kaylee and Showalter, a.k.a. food truck dude. It's possible. It's possible. I'll just say that. Maybe he thought he had a chance for whatever reason. And you know, all of this is kind of hearsay. All of this is hearsay. And I think that... I think a lot of this clearly shows him to be the top suspect. None of these people deserve this. The boyfriend of slain Idaho University student breaks his silence. This is Jake Schringer, the boyfriend of Madison Mogan. He spoke out at the vigil. That's that young man. Obviously, he's not. He said nobody deserved this at all. You know, so... It's clear nobody has suspected him at all, clearly. But I don't think he lived there. I think he was out of town. Idaho cops do admit that there was a stalker incident involving Idaho murder victim Kaylee Gonclaves at a local business, but they say the two men were ruled out. Now, they weren't stalking, according to what the investigation showed. Basically, the two men were there looking for women. But they never even spoke to the ladies, right? The update on Monday revealed that there were two males seen inside the unknown business before they parted ways. One male following Gonclaves inside the business. He was seen following her outside the business as she walked to her car. The male then turned away from her. He probably had cold feet. There was no stalking. He didn't talk to her at all. And then he got cold feet at the end. That's not a stalking incident. But I get it. People want to make a big deal out of it. Let's finish listening to what Joe had to say.
She was her, so Maddie was reaching into, she was, people were saying she never climbed in the grub bus. That's actually, maybe climbing's not the right word, but she was like reaching around inside the grub bus trying to grab food. And her friend Kaylee, who was the shorter one, was the one I think you're talking about. She had the camera held up high because she was trying to videotape Maddie reaching around inside the grub bus, which was part of the reason why the grub bus guy just gave them food, like, hey, don't be reaching in here, you know? And meanwhile, there's a driver that had pulled up for them, that was waiting for them, and he came out and was like, hey, what's going on? Let's go. So I don't know what, that's another rumor that's just spreading around. People are like, she was taking pictures of him. She wasn't taking pictures. She was I think it was Snapchat, if I remember correctly. She was like snapping somebody, or she was snapping Maddie being silly because Maddie was very drunk. Well, thanks for the clarification, because people are really running that with that comment. Yeah, I know. What kind of food do they sell? It looks so popular. Definitely would try it.
I don't care what kind of food they sell. You guys know where Joe's Ticker Tocker or whatever the fuck is. Guys, curious what you guys think about this. I think it's clear that Jack Showalter is the number one suspect. Dude was kicked out of the fraternity. Dude was kicked out of the same bar that night for being inappropriate to women. Dude, I think, was holding a knife. Obviously, he was creepy at the grub bus. Then his alibi is in the middle of the night, he drove 5 hours to his parents' cabin. Obviously, avid hunter, good with the knife. So he has the skills to do it. I'm going to be honest. To me, just like on day one, he's the number one suspect. What do you guys think? This seems obvious to me. Jack Showalter has to be considered the number one suspect at this very point in time. And now he's out of the country? Out of the country? Come on, man. Let me know in the comment section what you think. Do you think it's Jack? Do you think it's someone else? I know my boy Upgrade thinks it's a serial killer. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys like what I do here, you find my content valuable, feel free to hit the links down below. If you want to check out any of my other content, my live streams, things like that, it's politics and shit like that, though. So if you're a little bit, you know, left-leaning or a little limp-wristed shit like that, you probably don't want to follow me there. You get what I'm saying? You get what I'm saying? But if you guys want to check out some of my other channels, feel free to do that while you're down there. If you want to support the channel, your support is always appreciated. It's what allows me to do this each and every day as often as I do. Thank you guys so much. I'm JB Gunner. This has been Crime Time with JB Gunner. I think Jack did it. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.